Hey everybody, it's Christine. Welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be focusing on the new PhotoPlay paper collection, Winter Meadows. This is a really pretty collection that includes both winter themed stuff as well as Christmas, so you can use it for the entire season. I'm going to be just making a very classic style layout today, focused on this one adorable picture of my son playing with his gingerbread house. And as you can see, I've started off using this pretty plaid paper for my base of my layout, and then I've added a white square in the center that's a 10 by 10 square, and then I used this maroon patterned paper to back the photograph, and I use that almost to cover that entire left side because I liked this cut apart piece. This cut apart piece that came on one of the patterned papers said Merry Christmas and had these really pretty stars on it, and I just loved the whimsical feel of it, and I also liked the way it tied with the other elements that I wanted to include in this layout. So I decided to really make a big bold piece right down the left side there and make the picture the focal point of it, with drawing you down to the Merry Christmas title. Now here's the other piece that I really wanted to incorporate, this cute little bear on a sled. This collection has a lot of really fun, whimsical woodland creatures, but in a classic style. They're not cutesy, they're more of a traditional style and have more of those darker, woodsy feeling colors to them. So this bear on the sled, I thought he was just fun, and I thought he would look cute, like if he was going down a little hill of snow with that Merry Christmas saying there. So I decided to run with that and create a little scene at the bottom of my layout. I cut out a piece of white cardstock here, and I just made it into look like a hill, just, you know, with simple scissors. I didn't follow any template or anything. And then I'm gonna put that all the way across that 10 by 10 square. But first thing I'm gonna do is go over those hills with my scissors and just distress and rough up that top there. That'll just add a little bit of dimension to it and make that hill stand apart a little bit more from the rest of it. So I've added that on, and now I'm gonna go ahead and create a real simple but detailed background. Simple but detailed, there you go. So I'm using 1-inch circles in white, and I wanted them to mimic snowballs, and I just went all the way across and created horizontal scallops from the top to the bottom on that empty part of my layout. Just an easy way to add some really cool texture and a unique visually appealing design without having to use any fancy tools or techniques. And you know, a 1-inch punch, that's not hard to find. So I did that all the way across, and I just used lines to from my laser square to line those up. Now I'm going to do some final embellishing here. I'm going to add on a third part to my triangle. So you can see I have a triangle to the left side on the bottom of the layout and to the right side, and then my third point will be up there on the top right side, drawing the eye in. And that top one, I cut a banner from that same maroon patterned paper, and then I'm just adding Merry and Bright up there, and then I'm also just going to embellish with some of the cardstock stickers from the set. Now these are all different things: woodland, hearts, little quotes, little Christmassy and wintry sayings. You got a whole variety of stuff in there. So I'm focusing mostly on the hearts, presents, and pine cone pieces because they tied in well with the overall theme of my layout. And so I'm just adding those on in little clusters in each of those three spots. Now, back to those scallops. You can see right now I've got them on there and they're flat. And I am gonna just go with my pencil now and curl all those up, and you're gonna be amazed. It really brings a really pretty visual punch to the layout. But because they're all white, it's not overwhelming the rest of it. It just adds a nice little touch. Those scallops are lined up in every half inch. I have a new row starting. So it was, you know, I didn't focus too much on that because it could have gotten really tedious really fast to watch in the video. But you can see I just went line by line and did a half inch and then did another half inch and another half inch, and then just curling them up with a simple pencil here to add to the overall visual appeal of the whole thing. Now, some of these are tucked in behind the picture, and I'm going to just take my scissors and snip those a little bit so that I can pull those up a little bit more. And you can see, I wanted it really to have that snow falling feel, like it was snow coming down onto that bear. And I think I was able to achieve that. What I love is that when you can pull out a really simple tool like that and change the whole look of your layout just by doing that. So here's what I was talking about before, where I'm gonna have to just take my scissors and do a little snipping so that I can pull some of those up because the circles were tucked underneath the different edges. So that is just, you know, just a last minute thing that I realized, oh yeah, I could have done that a little differently and made it a little easier, but not a huge deal, especially if you have a fine tip scissors to just correct that and make it look better. I also wanted to do a little bit to up the visual appeal of the little snow hill there. So I decided what I would do is get out some aqua colored mist and a teeny tiny watercolor paintbrush and just put some shadows onto the hills down below. I'm not following any pattern, I'm not following any template, nothing. I'm just kind of eyeballing it and adding a little bit of that aqua blue all throughout very randomly. And that just, again, it brings the eye it gets some more attention to that, and it also just ups that visual appeal of the whole thing without being obnoxious or adding something that doesn't fit the rest of the layout. Now, the final thing I'm going to do is just add some enamel dots on here in a coordinating blue, and that will be it for today. So thank you so much for joining me here. Be sure to check out the links to these products down below. They're all available at scrapbook.com, and get your hands on this beautiful winter Christmas collection from Photoplay Paper. Have a great day.